Meet Anna. Anna works in a drug research lab. She loves her job because she feels it's the best way she can help people like her grandmother, who suffers from dementia. After years of work, Anna has discovered a molecule that may help treat Alzheimer's. If her drug succeeds, it will improve the lives of millions of people around the world and become a commercial success for her company. But Anna's journey has just begun. It's very difficult to bring a new drug to market. It'll have to go through years of trials and approvals, and if it does get commercialized, getting Anna's drug to patients will take doctors, marketers, insurers, pharmacists, and many other people playing their part. But that's the nature of the pharmaceutical industry. It's a complex $1.5 trillion business that creates and sells drugs to treat and cure diseases. Its products can mean life or death. And it has a number of key characteristics that make it different from other industries. It's built on high-risk investments. On average, it takes over $1 billion and a decade of work to bring a drug to market, and only 10% of drugs make it. Next, IP means everything. A patent, like the one Anna will file for her molecule, is a pharma company's main asset. It's also the company's core value driver, as it determines future cash flows. Also, pharma is highly regulated. There are rules governing every step of its life cycle, from research to sales. And although Anna's drug can help people around the world, it has to be approved by regulators in each country. And finally, reaching the end user is complicated. If you're just buying cereal, you can choose the brand you want, pay for it yourself, and have it whenever you like. But with a drug, the decision maker, the payer, and the user are often different people. A doctor decides who takes what, an insurer might pay for the drug, and the patient is the one who consumes it. The pharmaceuticals industry is complex, and it's often not very well understood, even though we all have some experience with it by taking medication. But in this primer, we'll break the industry down for you and help you understand everything from what drugs actually are and their different types, to what it takes to get a drug from the lab to your medicine cabinet, to the key trends in the industry.